Bless the Lord, all my soul, and all that is within me. Bless his holy name. Welcome to Wednesday with God, the online Bible study here at Unity Missionary Baptist Church in beautiful Baytown, Texas. Do us a favor, call a neighbor, call a friend. Let them know that Unity Baytown is on the air everywhere. And I want you to get your Bible, get you something to write with, get something to write on so you can take notes. And when this word applies to you, you can apply it to the, you can write it down and remember it and apply it to your daily life. We're so glad to have you on this wonderful Wednesday or whatever day you're watching. Why? Because this is the day that the Lord has made. We're going to rejoice and we're going to be glad in it. So come on, brothers and sisters, let's come in for Bible study. Let's get in our hearts together as we prepare to go into the Word of God on today. If you're only joining us on Wednesday evenings, you're missing half the fun. I invite you to join us every Wednesday at 12 noon in this same virtual space for the Sweet Hour of Prayer. It's about 10 or 15 minutes where the people of God come before the presence of God and we have a little talk with Jesus and tell him all about our troubles. So I invite you every Wednesday in this particular virtual space on Facebook and on YouTube to come with us as we go before the throne of God. You can also submit your prayer request at any time or your praise reports, and we'll be so happy to take them before the Lord on your behalf. We believe by faith prayer requests become praise reports. And so not only join us at 12 noon, but then come on back right now at the 7 p.m. hour and join us for Wednesday with God online Bible study. We're so happy that you're here. If this Bible study, if you've enjoyed it before and this has been a blessing to you, or if you this is your first time and you like what you're seeing, do three things for us. Number one, hit the like button. We invite you to like us. If you like it, like it. So hit that like button. Hit it as many times as you possibly can. Praise God. So hit the like button, but not only hit the like button, we want you to interact with us. So comment. Be sure to comment in the comment section. If you're being blessed by today's Bible study, if anything speaks to your heart, if anything ministers to you, we want you to please, ma'am, please, sir, join us. Comment, interact. If the Word of God touches you in any place, make sure you interact in the Bible study. And then lastly, tag and share. Somebody may need to hear this word that you're about to receive. So you never know who this word may touch. We've been told that this goes global. This goes all over the nation. And so our goal, our desire is to get the gospel of Jesus Christ around the world. That's what he told us to do in Matthew chapter 28. Go into all the world, teach all nations. And so we invite you to, when you tag and share this, what you do is you become a catalyst to help us get this word across the entirety of the world. Would you help us do that? Like, comment, tag, and share. And so you would be a conduit to help us get the word of God out to the people of God. Amen? Thank you so much. Again, welcome to Wednesday with God online Bible study. Thank those of you who are coming in and chiming in. Go ahead and let people know that we're here. And before we get into the word of God, we're going to talk to God one more time and ask him to bless the hour that we're about, this time that we're about to spend together. But before we do that, I want to offer you the opportunity to sow into this ministry. If this ministry is being a blessing to you, if you have received anything good from this, the Apostle Paul said, if we've sown unto you carnal spiritual things, is it not much that we reap your carnal? Those of you who are members of the church, we invite you to take this moment to sow your tithes and offerings. If we were in person, we would pass a plate across to you. But today we want to offer you a virtual offering plate. The information is there on your screen where you can pay your tithes and offerings to the ministry. And so you can be a blessing. You do know this, that you can use the website. Go to the website and click online giving, follow the prompts. It is safe and it is secure. Number two, you can also use text to give, or you can mail your tithes and offerings to the church. The address is right there on the screen. Also, If you have a love gift for the man of God, that being the pastor, if you have a love gift and you would like to sow into the pastor, the information is there via Cash App as to how you can be a blessing to the man of God. Bible does say, he that sows into you, sow unto him. The Apostle Paul says, those that preach the gospel receive their living from the gospel. And so tithes and offerings are good, but also when you sow into the man of God, you're not only being a blessing, but you set yourself up to be blessed. And so we invite you, if the Lord leads you to sow into the man of God, it is a biblical principle how to bless the pastor. And so with that, we want to thank you for your gifts to the kingdom and to the minister. Now, let's go before God in prayer as we prepare to receive the word of God. Father, we thank you today for this moment. Thank you for watching over us all day long. Thank you for keeping us and blessing us and protecting us and watching over us. We ask now in the name of Jesus that as we dive into your word, that you would help us to understand what it is you're saying in this hour. God, I thank you for your people who are coming in today. I pray that you would give them what they need for this moment, for this hour. Speak to us as only you can. Get rid of every hindrance. Get rid of every distraction. Anything that's not like you, cancel it right now so that we can be what you want us to be. And God, will be so quick and careful to give your name the praise, the honor, and the glory. And it is so. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. All right. God bless you. God keep you, is our prayer. Again, welcome to Wednesday with God online Bible study. And with that being said, let's get your Bibles. Go to the book of Jeremiah, chapter number 3. Jeremiah chapter number 3. We started a teaching entitled A Present Called Pastor. October is Clergy Appreciation Month, and so today we want to pick up where we left off about the present called pastor. Jeremiah chapter 3, verse 15, and we're reading from the New King James Version. The Apostle Paul simply said, the prophet Jeremiah says, and I will give you pastors according to mine heart, which shall feed you with knowledge and understanding. The word of God for the people of God. Again, we're talking about a present called pastor. Now, for those of you who were not with us last time, we started off by telling you what the definition in the Old Testament of a pastor is. It is somebody who tends to, or who shepherds, who rules, who teaches, literally, figuratively, feeding a flock. So the primary roles, we talked about the primary roles in minute detail. A part of those roles are to feed the flock, to take care of them. Another one is to provide for or protect them. And what do you, as a pastor, we are called to protect the sheep from outside influences, from wolves. What do you mean wolves? Wolves are those animals that come to prey on the people of God. I kind of gave you a scope of what pastors do last week. Sometimes pastors don't let everyone preach in their pulpit or teach their people. And that's as it should be. Because as a pastor, the assignment is to make sure that the diet that God gives the pastor, he or she disseminates to the people of God. Because our job is to make sure that you are healthy when the chief shepherd comes. Now, as a shepherd, I am, and those who are pastors, serve as under-shepherds to the chief shepherd, who is Jesus Christ. So we are deputized to protect the people as Jesus himself would protect the people. And I know some people will say, well, Jesus is my shepherd, he's my bishop, and that is true. He is the ultimate shepherd, he is the chief shepherd. However, in Ephesians chapter number 4, he told us last week that he gave us apostles, prophets, evangelists, pastors, and teachers. Verse 12, for the perfecting of the saints, for the work of the ministry, for the edifying of the body of Christ. So pastors, along with the other four of the fivefold, have an intricate part in the church, because what they do is they are the local feeders of the congregation. They are the pastor is the consistent feeder of the congregation. His or her assignment is to make sure that you and I receive the word of God. Now, we talked about that. There are three distinct assignments that the pastor has. There are three distinct assignments that the pastor has. I've caught you up from last week, and today I want to get into, let me deal with at least one of those assignments. And then we'll pick these up as the days go on. But I want you to appreciate what the pastor does, what goes into this assignment, this call that the men and women of God take on. Now, for those of you who don't have a pastor, get one. Please ask God to give you a shepherd that will give you what God would have them to give you. That's why it is important to have a church home, so that when you have a church home, you will have a pastor, a senior pastor, whose primary job is to give you what God would have him or her to give you. So, I think I've talked about my first point. My first assignment as a pastor is a feeder. The pastor is a feeder. Now, if you're in Jeremiah chapter 3, listen to what he says. He says, and I will give you pastors according to my heart. First of all, get understand, God will not give a pastor that does not act like him, walk like him, talk like him, think like him. Because the pastor is the spiritual leader of the church. The pastor is to step in the shoes of Christ and to fulfill the obligation of being God's representative on planet Earth. That's why he says, I'll feed you with, I will give you pastors after my heart, who will do for you like I would do for you. And his first or her first job is to feed you. All right, so the feeding, when a pastor feeds, a pastor, number one, feeds from the heart of God. That's why he said, I will give you pastors after my heart. In other words, when the pastor stands, they're going to give you the word of God from the heart of God. They're going to tell you what thus saith the Lord as it goes from the word of God. Because one thing we must understand, beloveds, God will not go outside the perimeters of his word. We always want, we're living in a day and age where people want fresh word. We want a fresh oil, a fresh revelation. Beloveds, let's be honest. In the search for getting something new, we haven't yet mastered the old. So therefore, we must understand there's an entirety of word that has been given to us that we have not comprehended just yet. And so God says, I'm going to feed you the diet that I feel is necessary for you. Why is that so essential? Because you and I are not our own. Got it? You and I are not our own. Okay? If you have your Bibles, and I didn't even pull this up, Psalm 100. I want to just give that to you. Psalm 100. I want to show you that you are not your own property. So you got to stop thinking for yourself. Please stop thinking for yourself. Psalm 100. Verse number 3. Psalm 100, verse number 3. Got it? Psalm 100, verse 3, it says, Know ye that the Lord, he is God. It is he who has made us, and not we ourselves. We are his people and the sheep of his pasture. So with that being said, we must understand the property principle of God. We are his by ownership. He purchased us with his blood through Jesus Christ. So the pastor is a feeder from the heart of God. What will he feed us? He will feed us knowledge. That's what he's going to feed us. That's what the shepherd has been assigned to feed, knowledge. Something that we can comprehend, something that we can chew. What sense does it make to give a baby a steak when the baby can't chew on steak? They barely can handle a bottle. Now, I want to say something, and I mean no harm, but in the words of my father in the ministry, I mean all the harm in the world. If you can't grasp the basic concepts of the word, you're not ready for strong meat. Because there are some things in some of these basic verses you and I have not mastered yet. And if you haven't mastered the small things, you're not ready for the big things. And there are many people who leave the flocks. They'll leave their pastors, going to other churches and other conferences, looking for something different, looking for something bigger, looking for something that tastes better. But everything that's outside the house is not on your diet. Amen. I know they hate me when I do it, but I have a daughter. Her name's Judah. Judah has a diet unlike her other siblings. There are some things she cannot eat. So whenever she dines at the table, as her father, I have to be cognizant of the fact that there are certain things her stomach cannot hold or digest because it's a part of her diet. Now, if she goes somewhere and gets something for somebody else and they feed it to her, it's not their fault because they don't know Judah's diet. And many of you, when you leave your churches trying to get a word, I'm not saying that it's wrong to go visit other churches, but remember, God gives your pastor your specific diet. Amen. God gives your pastor your specific diet. We think, you know, there are other churches, and yes, there are other churches and other preachers who are well versed in scripture. But one flock has been designed with a specific diet given to one shepherd. Amen. And so you can tell when your child has gone off and eaten somewhere else, because when they come back home, they're not hungry. Got it? And so you, beloveds, go where your diet is specifically made. The pastor is supposed to give you knowledge of God's word, number one. That's what we're supposed to feed you. This is your diet. This is your food. This is what's going to be on the plate every time you come to eat. Now, there are those who say, I'm not getting what I need. The question is, are you coming to get it? Because some people say, I don't like what's being fed. Some kids don't like spinach. Some kids don't like vegetables. Some of them don't like, greens, leafy foods. But it is for your benefit. Now, you and I should be glad that God is not like our forefathers, our parents of old. Because our parents of old say, you know what? You can choose not to eat it if you want to. But either you're going to eat or go to bed hungry. You had a parent like that too, huh? I did, yeah. You're going to eat what I put on this table or you're going to go hungry. Now, why am I saying that? Because God is not so, he's not evil. He's not mean where you can't, you got an option to go wherever you want to go. But if you're saved, you've been assigned to a local congregation. And that shepherd has the responsibility of feeding you what's on that what's on your menu. Everybody cannot handle steak. Some of you just have to handle applesauce. Everybody can't handle applesauce. Some of you need Similac. And there's nothing wrong with that. There are different levels for each and every one of us. But you got to go to the place where you're supposed to be fed. Got it? So, we're being fed God's word, but number two, we're being fed God's will. When you understand the word, Deacon McLemore, who's gone on to be with the Lord, he used to tell us in Sunday school, you cannot know God's will until you know God's word. You must understand what God's will is for your life. Now, God's will is for your will to be up under his will. Got it? God's will is for you to submit to him so that in all things, it'll never be what you want per se. It'll be what God wants. Because again, when you get saved, it's not what you will. It's what God wills. And our problem is when we want to do God's will our way, it's a setup for failure. Got it? So, we're being taught God's will, and we're being taught God's word. We're fed from the heart of God knowledge, but then number two, we are fed understanding. Okay? Let's see here. If you have your Bibles, go to John chapter 15, the Gospel of John, excuse me. John chapter 15, John chapter 15. I want to go to verse number 13. Okay? John chapter 15, verse 13. It says, greater love hath no man than this, that man lay down his life for his friends. You are my friends if you do what I command. Did you see that? I no longer call you servant, but I call you, but because a servant does not know what his master does. Instead, I have called you friend, for everything I have learned from the Father I have made known to you. You did not choose me. I chose you and appointed you to go and bear fruit that will last. And the Father will give you whatever you ask in my name. This is my commandment. Love you one another. Why did I read that scripture? Because Jesus says you cannot be called one of the disciples, one of my disciples, if you're operating under your own will. So we must understand whatever has been taught to us or being fed to us. I pastor a church that is African American. And so in the African-American community, we get a little excited at worship. Y'all know we do. We clap our hands. We shout. God is good. We dance. We run. You know, we affirm the preached word at preaching time. Amen, Pastor. Preach, Pastor. We shout. We give God all the glory. But what good is it to have all of that response, call and response, and there's no understanding? Can I ask you a question? What did your pastor preach last week? What was the sermon? What was the text? What was the topic? What were the points? What was the thesis? But what you can remember is Pastor Scholl preached. If Pastor really effectively preached, you would remember what was said. Write it down. That's why it's good to take notes during the sermon so that you can get an understanding. Watch this. You may not get an understanding now, but you'll get it as you go. What am I supposed to understand? And I'm done. You're supposed to understand God's word. That's why God's word or God's way. But then you're supposed to understand God's worth. When you understand the word, you'll understand God's way, which is the word, and then you'll understand God's worth. What is he worth to you? That's what worship means. What is God worth to you? But you'll never know what God's worth is to you if you don't first understand the word. Faith comes by hearing. Hearing by the word of God. How can they hear without a preacher? What am I trying to preach to you? I'm trying to preach that one day on a hill called Calvary, Jesus Christ died for you. He gave his life. And since he gave his life, the Bible says, whoever will call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved. Beloveds, God, the chief shepherd, wants you to accept him today. If you're watching me and you're watching this and you have not said yes to Jesus Christ, I invite you to give your life to the Lord today. He wants to save you just as you are, regardless of what your hangups or hiccups are. He wants to save you just as you are. What do I need to do? Confess the Lord Jesus Christ. Believe on him and you shall be saved. It's as simple as that. Would you like to accept Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior? It's as simple as praying a prayer. Pray this prayer with me. And when you pray it, say it with your mouth, but believe it in your heart. And God will hear you and answer your prayer. Are you ready? Let's pray. God, I come to you, a sinner. I repent of my sin. Forgive me. Come into my life and save me. I believe in Jesus Christ. He is the Son of God. He died for my sin and rose from the dead. Father, fill me with your Holy Spirit. Lead me. Guide me. And I will live for you the rest of my life. Thank you for saving me. In Jesus' name, amen. If you prayed that prayer, welcome to the body of Christ. I'm so excited for you. You made the best decision of your life. Now, find you a Bible-teaching, Bible-believing church where Jesus Christ is exalted and the Word of God is taught and explained. When you get there, get baptized in water. The first commandment that Jesus told us is to be baptized. Baptism is an outward sign that you have accepted Jesus Christ as your Lord. It's a testimony. It says, the water doesn't save me, but the Word has already saved me. Jesus Christ said, he that believes and is baptized shall be saved. He that believes not is damned. So, you can be baptized, but if there's no belief, then you have not done anything but gone into the water. But I encourage you, accept the Lord Jesus Christ. Find your Bible teaching church. Get baptized in water. Join that church. I invite you to become a part of the wonderful church of Baytown called Unity Missionary Baptist Church. What's so wonderful about this church? It is a place where everybody is somebody. The information is on the screen as to how you can become a part of this wonderful congregation of people. They're just like you and me, from all walks of life, from all nationalities, all ethnicities. And they come and we worship the Lord Jesus Christ and we study his word. Come be a part of this wonderful congregation. We would love to have you as our brother and sister. I would love to be your pastor. You need a church home. You watch Unity every week, but you're not officially connected. Connect with us to the information you see on the screen. And we would love to have you as our brother and sister in the Lord Jesus Christ. Don't delay. Come on and join us. There's a space in the place for your faith. Amen. Well, I hope you enjoyed today's Bible study. If this has been a blessing to you, share it with somebody else. We got to go. Lord's will, I hope to see you Sunday in worship. Until then, may the rest of your week be the best of your week. The blessing of the Lord be upon you. We bless you in the name of the Lord. Peace and favor.